when I was a boy, 5 years old, I, 6 years old, perhaps, I used the library in the children's room downstairs. I remember that day very well, as though it were just yesterday. I learned to swim here in the swimming pool when I was a youngster. I used the gym upstairs. I used the adult library. I attended many affairs in the music hall throughout the years. In 1962, I became librarian here. And I was a librarian here until 1974 when the building closed. And I always had the hope that it could be opened, even though there were many negative responses about that. Specifically, they were tear it down. What, $1 million? What are they going to do with it if you do get it restored and so forth? But we in the Historical Society, persisted, and it looks as though we're seeing some light now at the end of the tunnel. Got a barrier here. Funds for the library were allocated by Andrew Carnegie in 1881. The building was started about 1886. It was finished and opened in 1889. In 1893, the music hall and the swimming pool were built. In 1914, there was a 25th anniversary celebration. Andrew Carnegie was here. That was his last talk in this country before he went back to his hometown, Dunfermline, Scotland. There was a slack period beginning about perhaps 1940, and I think it was during that time that the Carnegie Library Corporation got the idea it wanted to try to unload its property. And in 1961, this building was deeded over to the Braddock School District.
Did you ever use the library, Doc?
Huh?
Did you ever use the public library?
Oh, yeah, I used a lot of time. I used a lot of time just to go for a swim in. Good time. In fact, I even showed movies up there one time about 16mm
camera. Remember the minstrels they used to have?
16mm movie camera.
The minstrels they used to have?
Sure. I was in my junior year, I was in a play with, what's her name, Miss McGarry? Miss McGarry?
Betty McGarry.
Yeah, Mrs. Betty McGarry. We got to play at the Carnegie Library.
Carnegie Hall.
Yeah. Oh, that was a beautiful place.
Yeah, I used to live with her. And swimming. Back in, 55, 56.
We went swimming there. We used to go, when I was a child going to school, I used to go up there and get my fairy tale books. It was a beautiful library. It's nice in there.
Our children in this community, I think, is being robbed. Robbed by those of us that care only about our own personal gains and where our plight is carrying us. Have no concern for a building of this type today because of the fact it's only going to benefit a special fraction of people, poor and majority black.
And I remember coming here when I was a youngster, and there were leagues and basketball leagues.
Yeah.
Every day there was some basketball games in the evening, and there were playoffs, and not only basketball games, there were all kinds of athletic activities.
Yeah.
In the years when the building was open.
Back here is where we had sauna bath.
Yeah, there was a sauna bath here, and it's gone now. This was a kitchen. This always was a kitchen as far as I know. When there were many affairs held in this building, the food was prepared here. And I just, another storage room, and there's some old Braddock High School band uniforms in here. This is the room I was telling you about. It was made into a ladies' dressing room. Originally, it was a checkers playing room. See the archway there? See the evidence of the archway right there? And if you want to see the new Transformers, that's my real, what I think is evidence of progress. Here's the new Transformers.